seen records broken week in and week out this SEC gymnastics season. Gymnasts made every 10th count in front of the biggest crowds. Take it to
another level. So much energy in here. I love it. They love her. Gymnastics love her. We all love her.
And in the SEC, it just means more. These eight teams have shown they are battle-tested and can achieve greatness. Yeah, you're almost
there. You can almost touch the- LSU does it at home.
These Mizzou Tigers just keep on cooking.
We've got ourselves a competition.
Their hard work and dedication is evident, and they have proven they can attain perfection.
The best in NCAA gymnastics, maybe even in the world.
There's almost no way you can't give that a perfect 10.
Nothing less than perfection will be good enough.
Today, the most high-flying gymnast in the country will leave it all on the floor. It's time to cement this season's story for the most storied conference in college gymnastics.
Welcome everybody inside Gas South Arena here in Duluth, Georgia, for our live coverage of the 20.
To me, they're one of the most impressive teams in the country right now because despite the adversity, they continue to be successful each week by improving in their team scores and in the rankings. They have had to rely on a lot of depth throughout this season, so the next up mentality is not new for them. Of course, these are the athletes that are going to be unavailable in tonight's competition. So even though we won't see them competing tonight, you will see them on the sideline cheering like their life depends on it. So it's still a team effort for everyone on the LSU roster.
All right, thank you, Sam. Well, tonight should be an exciting meet. The SEC is the only conference to have every team ranked in the top 20. We've seen close competition every week in the regular season, and tonight will be no different.
Competing in the SEC regular season is the best preparation for postseason.
You're competing against the top in the country.
Every single weekend, we know we're always going to get the best competition.
It might be easier to win the national championship than the SEC championship.
Everybody, Mark Connor, along with Kathy Johnson-Clark and Sam Peschek, we are set to go in session two tonight. They will champion, they will award the champions in the SEC. In your upper left corner is Florida starting on the vault. You can watch all these routines simultaneously on the app if you'd like to go there to the SEC Network Plus. Every event has its own channel, plus you can watch the all-around channel with every event going at once. So leading off for Florida on the upper left is Peyton Richards. She'll be on the vault. In the upper right is Alexis Jeffrey from LSU on the bars. In the lower left is Ella Burgess, the leadoff for Alabama on beam. And in your bottom right, it's Jillian Prokaski, who will lead off for Kentucky on the floor.
Peyton Richards, 1.5. Looked like a pretty good landing. Hard to see with the coach right there, but starting with a 10-0 start value. Big advantage for Florida. They will show 5 vaults that are 10-0 start value.
This is essentially a 4-ring circus with all 4 events going on simultaneously. This is different than regular dual meet competition.
Alexis Jeffrey swinging aggressively. Great routine. Not quite a stick on the landing, but a tremendous job hitting those handstands.
Alabama is led off by Ella Burgess, who is typically in this leadoff spot. Alabama was second last year. 2 years ago, they won this.
Ella opened with a one-arm back handspring to a layout step off of her acro series. She is such a superb beam leadoff performer. Calm, confident, very deliberate. Jillian with a double tuck on floor exercise, a little short of rotation, so she stepped forward.
There's something about Alabama at the SEC Championship. It's like they come alive. Even when they sometimes don't have the best regular season, they are always a contender. Never count them out. 10 times they've won the SEC title, 6 times the national championship.
They have steadily improved, Bart, from week one to now, and they're seeing it. Great job, Ella Burgess, on balance beam.
Moments ago on vault, Leanne Wong coming after Peyton Richards got a 9.825.
Difficult vault, half on, front pike half. Great job with a very complicated 10.0 start value vault.
Olivia Dunn now coming up for LSU. Only her third time in the lineup this year. Most of the season she was out with a stress reaction in her left ankle.
This event is her specialty. She'll open with a nice combination. Tkachev right into the pack salto. Well done. It's really worked on the fine details. Short on that final cast of handstand. They'll take a little deduction there. Let's see if she can keep those legs locked in the double layout. One of the best dismounts I've seen her perform.
Sloane Blakely for Florida now on the vault.
Rapid fire madness now with a phenomenal.
Oh, yeah,
she knows it.
And she's coming after Leanne Wong's 9.9. Jenny Rowland, the head coach at Florida, she knows what she's got. She has a stacked team in terms of talent and accolades.
She just was right on this vault. Got a good block off the table.
Quick reminder how the SEC championship works. Seeds 5 through 8 competed earlier this afternoon. Auburn won that session. The top four are competing now. All four apparatus will go simultaneously. 6 gymnasts on each event for each team. You count just the best 5 of 6 scores towards their team totals. This is a little different than regular season. There are 4 judges here instead of the regular season, 2 judges. They drop the high and the low scores and they average the 2 scores in the middle. So we go back to Kayla DiCello, who's had just a standout year for a freshman here at Florida, Kathy.
They have phenomenal scores so far on vault. If Kayla can stick the landing, they will keep this momentum going. 1.5 twist vault.
Blakely had a 9.95.
Great distance, but unfortunately a big distance on the hop as well. They will take a deduction for that big hop.
Tori Tatum coming after the second 9.85 in a row for LSU on bars after Jeffrey and Olivia Dunn.
Big combination, Ray into the pack salto, just a little leg separation, transitioning down to low, but wow, right on top of the bar for that half pirouette. A little short on the final cast. Full twist and got it back. Superb landing.
Oh, Kathy, it's been fun to follow this team at LSU. They've lost some of their stars. And she stepped up like many athletes 9 times in the lineup and has delivered again on bars. Talking about superstars, here is Trinity Thomas, one of the greatest of all time. You can see she is right now in 4th with 25 career perfect 10s in her graduate season, going for the record. And she's scored 6 perfect 10s in the postseason in her career, so it is possible.
Absolutely. She checks off all the boxes on this ball. Great approach, terrific block, and a huge amplitude on that ball. Look at the distance. She almost landed face to face with the coach at the end of the mat.
That's Adrian Berta, the assistant coach, longtime assistant coach at Florida. He's out of Romania. He's been there 17 years. He is a mile away from the vault table.
Notice.
And you're right, she almost goes all the way to him.
Notice that block really got her up in the air 9 feet from the table. That is huge distance, just little deduction on the landing.
DiCello had a 9.8 after bouncing around on her landing. Talk about athletes who have stepped up for LSU. Leah Finnegan has been a superb all-around competitor, very consistent all year long.
Terrific level of difficulty in this routine and an unusual release move right here, a pike delchav. Very difficult. Perfect handstand position. Vertical on that transition to lay bar. And she has an interesting dismount as well. Then a half turn right here into the double front. Blind landing, she has to feel it, takes the step. But a great routine.
Ariana Patterson now on floor for Kentucky. Their high score over there is Mackenzie Wilson, 9.825.
Great height on that 1.5 twist into the front layer.
Patterson, the 50-year senior out of Plano, Texas. The last four meets on floor, 9-9 or better.
Difficult leap here in this series. Switch ring with a half twist. Need a little bit more knee bend in the back leg. Beautiful amplitude. Oh, there's the ring position and the straddle, just gorgeous.
Season 10-3, only two losses in the SEC.
Final pass, double tuck, nice height, good control. Excellent.
Kentucky has slowly improved all year long, eight times over 197. As we go back to bars, Aaliyah Finnegan had a 9.85. Here's Alona Shinnikova.
Ooh, she caught just a little bit close to the bar on that high ball release. When those arms are bent on the regress, that shows her a little close. Double layout, almost gets the stick, just not
quite. Well, she travels far away from that bar.
So this is the judge's view. They sit on the side and notice when she catches how close her face is to the bar. She does a good job, though, of pushing away as she regrasps.
Moments ago, the final vaulter for Florida coming after Trinity Thomas got a 9.875.
This is the one full twist in the lineup. It's a 9.95 start value, so she tries to be perfect. Big amplitude, excellent technique, just a little bit of a pogo stick landing.
Just her sixth time in the lineup on vault. Last week, her season high was a 9.85. So solid opening rotation for Florida. You see that score there in your bottom right. 49.375 is their score on vault in rotation one. Obviously, vault goes faster than the other three events. That's why vault is complete. Haley Bryant set to go now on bars.
And I want everyone to appreciate how aggressively she casts her handstands, snaps those legs together to really emphasize the vertical position. These little details, these parts of gymnastics, that's what the judges scrutinize.
High score for LSU so far is Tori Tatum's 9.9. We need a big score here from Bryant.
First cast right there. Here's the blind change. Big straddle Jaeger. Ooh, a little close, but she managed it well. Bail right to the vertical handstand. Well done. And she will set up a dismount. She has gotten so good at finding this landing. It's a double front with a half twist. Oh, a little scoop back. But a really nice routine.
She needs a 9.95 to pass Florida in this first rotation.
Love that blind change, went right to vertical. Notice how she pushed away and got the swing back going and into the dismount, just a little scoot.
Haley Bryant, 11 times in the all-around this year for LSU. Jay Clark, their head coach there, over 30 years coaching. And he's the third year as the head coach. 8 years he was an assistant and an associate head coach to coaching legend Dee Dee Brough, who retired after 43 years as the dean of coaches in the SEC. And Jay Clark really has had some challenges this year with his team because some of his big scoring athletes went down with injuries, and yet they seem to continue to stay relevant and consistent. Tuesday night on the SEC Network and the ESPN app, our next SEC Inside grants you an all-access pass to the Gymnastics Championship at 9 Eastern, 8 Central. You'll get never-before-seen footage and sound from gymnasts and coaches, a real behind-the-scenes look. All right, over on the beam with Alabama. Let's go down to Sam Pesci.
Yeah, thanks, Bart. I talked to Ashley, and she was describing Lily Hudson, and she said, all I can say, she's a freaking rock. She brings this ultra-competitive personality to the team that's amazing. So the focus this week is really treating it like spring break, because that's what Alabama is on right now, spring break. So they want to bring a playful attitude, especially heading into this first rotation on beam.
You mentioned Ashley Priest-Johnson, her first year as the head coach at Alabama, a former Alabama all-around gymnast, as we look to the floor as well for Kentucky.
Haley Davis for Kentucky on floor exercise with a rock and roll routine.
High score for Kentucky so far over there is Ariana Patterson's 9-9.
Lily Hudson can be so clean on this event with very straight legs, good footwork. Solid work on beam so far. Alabama really wants to finish up with these final two routines. They're really good beam routines. Needs a little bit more amplitude on those leaps. Might have gotten a little bit nervous there. Finish on floor, a tuck double back. Boy, I can hear the Kentucky fans in the stands. Rock on, well done. And the dismount here, round up 1.5 twist, a hop on the landing, giving away a few little tenths of a point. They're minor, but they do add up.
The high score for Alabama on the beam so far with their leadoff competitor, Ella Burgess. You see Ashley Priest-Johnson there giving some notes. Well, I think back to Ashley as a competitor, Kathy. How many times did we call her routine and she came up with a clutch performance at the end to secure a national championship for Alabama?
Every time, and I love that she told us later that that really didn't come naturally to her. She had to work to become that clutch beam performer. And that's what makes a great coach, when you have felt both sides of it.
4 years she was the associate head coach at Auburn, and now back at her alma mater, this is her first year as their head coach. Luisa Blanco will be coming up next, who has just been superb throughout her career at Alabama, SEC Gymnast of the Year back in 2021. It was the same year she was the NCAA champion on beam, 12-time All-American. Four career tens on this event, beam, and a couple of years ago, it was here at the SEC Championships that she basically won it all.
She went lights out.
She did.
On every event, and she can be stunning on balance beam.
Lily Hudson scores in now. It's a 9.85. So they have three 9.85s and a 9.875 are their best four scores so far.
From the big things to the little details, she is so beautiful, so elegant and polished on beam.
Talk about stars. Raina Worley now on beam floor for Kentucky after Haley Davis notched a 9.925.
Beautiful. Tuck full in on floor exercise. Here comes the triple series for Luisa Blanco on beam. Oh, only did one layout step out. She doesn't need the second layout step out. Beautiful needle scale showing off the flexibility. Pass on a perfectly stuck landing.
talk about what's at stake here. Worley on floor, a 9-9 for Kentucky would take the lead over Florida. However, if Blanco gets a 9-9-7-5 on beam for Alabama, they could move into the lead.
She is on her way to a huge score. Oh! That was phenomenal. Whoa! On beam. Absolutely stunning.
What is it about Alabama and the SEC championships?
And Reyna finishing up with a tuck double back, a little hop forward. Oh, that was really the only error that I saw. It was so minor, just a teeny hop forward.
What a start to session two here at the SEC championships. Florida coming in as a odds-on favorite, but everyone else pouring it on.
That is just pure grace, so exquisite.
Larissa Blanco proud of that effort. And of course, Alabama chose to start on the beam in this session, and that takes a lot of courage. Now, would you rather start on beam or finish on beam, or do you not care?
Well, actually, they didn't choose Bart. Kentucky chose floor,
right,
and left beam for Alabama. So in all honesty, you take what you get and mm-hmm. you make it the best thing.
Well,
so
it was,
I love starting.
We've seen
beam.
Many times where Alabama finishes on the beam to win it all too. So they've done it both ways, but great start there. Looks like Florida and Alabama are now tied with a 49-3-7-5, 5/100ths of a point ahead. Sloan Blakely.
And you rarely see sass on Vault, but here it is, the look to the judges. I got this. Showed off height, distance, control.
That's fun.
Had it all. And just pure, gorgeous work on beam.
All right, let's go down to Sam Peschek. She's with Alabama's head coach, Ashley Johnson-Priest.
Ashley, you guys steadily improved throughout the lineup. What do you think about that first rotation?
I'm really proud of them for that first rotation. We're really focusing on going big and letting it rip. That's really been, you know, how we've approached every single moment, and I'm really excited about how we just started.
What are you hoping to see on the next event?
You know, same thing. We've got to carry our speed over to floor, not hold back. We can't take a cautious approach. We really got to go after those takeoffs and command the landings and just take it one thing at a time.
Thanks, Ashley.
Thank you.
All right, we've talked a lot about Trinity Thomas and the Gators team. They're not short on talent. When we get back, we'll take a look at some U.S. national team members who've swapped the red, white, and blue for orange, white, and blue.
Welcome back to the SEC Championships. We just wrapped up rotation number one here in the second session, and Kentucky is in the lead, but all four teams are separated by less than 1/10. We knew it was going to be close here. Now, one of Florida's athletes, Trinity Thomas, is somebody that we talk about a lot, and for good reason. But the rest of Florida's lineup is stacked. They also have lengthy gymnastics resumes. I always joke with head coach Jenny Rowland because I don't possibly know how she chooses lineups, because they have such a deep lineup full of amazing gymnasts with experience. Seven of their athletes, in fact, have been part of the U.S. national team. Four of them competed at World Championships, and two of these athletes, Leanne Wong and Kayla DiCello, are both currently on the senior national team, while also participating here in the NCAA season, which is incredibly tough to do. So, what's the difference between elite and college gymnastics, you ask? I talked to Leanne Wong earlier this week to find out.
I would say collegiate just more about execution, but in elite, you're trying to do difficulty and execution, so you want to put like your hardest skills you can out there while being clean, but in college, it's mostly about perfection.
Not only do the Gators know about elite gymnastics, they also know a little something about perfection. Between these three athletes, they have 10 perfect 10s, the most of any team in the country. And it's harder to get 10s in the postseason, but Trinity Thomas has proven it can be done. She's hoping to get another one today.
Here, tiny
teams in the SEC. Well, last year's NCAA championships, half of the teams came from this conference. Currently, four teams in the top 10. That's the most of any conference in the country. Five of the top 10 all-around gymnasts this season are from the SEC. All right, now because they're competing in two separate sessions, this is the only way we can actually compare all the teams based on the rotations, okay? So after the first rotation, here is the standings, including the teams who already competed this afternoon. So Kentucky, Florida, Alabama, and Missouri would be the top four. Kentucky with that 49-4, and Raina Worley's 9-9 on floor has surged into the lead. A reminder, you can watch every single routine on the SEC Network. Plus, each event has its own channel. Plus, you can watch the all-around channel with every event going at once. All right, second rotation on the vault is Kentucky with Jillian Prokaski. On the bars up in the upper right is Sloane Blakely from Florida. In the lower left, it's Elena Arenas from LSU on beam. And down on the lower right, Alabama's Maddie Walagora on floor.
What a start for Kentucky. She was offline, though. Notice she landed on that white line to the left of the table. That should be a slight deduction for direction. And on bars, Florida, the number two ranked team in the nation on this event. They have got to take advantage of the strength of this event for them.
Talk about the quality of gymnastics. There were 24 routines performed in the first rotation. Every one was a hit. And all of these teams separated by just a tenth.
Florida just started with a stick.
Something about Sloane Blakely, she just seems to bring it and set an energy and a mood for the Gators.
Elena Reynes stepped into this event early in the season and has done a tremendous job. Now we've got a go on floor exercise. Dismount, almost a stick, hop forward, but good start for LSU on beam.
Arenas just missed one meet, the first meet of the year, but her season high is a 9.925 there.
Back one and a half to front layout. Very clean form and position in the air.
Walagora, the senior from Rochester, Michigan, in every lineup for the Crimson Tide this year. Moments ago, Mackenzie Wilson for Kentucky on vault.
Our first look at a front pike with a half twist on this vault. 10-0 start value. Wow. Very nicely done. Just the hop, little slide on that landing.
She was in every meet this year for Kentucky. Had a 9.975 in their dual meet with Auburn. Ariana Patterson set to go now.
And Kentucky does three of these front pike half vaults. We're seeing more of those in NCAA gymnastics. She can fly when she times this block perfectly. Very well done. That may be her best vault of the season.
Victoria Wynn on bars for Florida Gators. 9-9 was the score in the leadoff spot for Sloane Blakely.
Lovely work so far on this routine. Double layout with another stick.
0-1 Field, the assistant coach at Florida. In his eighth season, he does great work with this team on the bars.
One of the requirements, you have to transfer from bar to bar twice. She did it beautifully, and that was the view that the judges get right on the side.
Isabella Magnelli will go now for Kentucky on the vault. So the score just came in for Walagora, 9.875 for Alabama on the floor. The quality of gymnastics we're seeing tonight is unreal. Everywhere you look is top class execution, and NCAA gymnastics as good as it gets.
This is exactly what you hope for in a meet like this. Everyone hitting their best routines. Another pike run half here. Huge amplitude, great landing, not a stick, but a great landing, and all three of those vaults were really well executed and very high.
Tim Garrison told me that this is actually their first time on podium all year, and they struggled a bit yesterday in practice adjusting to the equipment, but guys, I don't see any struggles today with their vault landings.
Good point. The podium is a 3.5-foot riser, basically. It's like a staging system you would see at a concert. All the equipment put up on the podium. It's all a little bit springier and wobblier up there, wouldn't you say?
I don't know about you guys. I love podium for vault.
Yeah, well, you get a little extra bounce, that's for sure. But it's not always easy to control.
Exactly.
Kayla DiCello now on bars.
And she can fly on this event. Big Ray, beautiful amplitude, and she's so aggressive on these handstands, hitting the position. Oh, and connected that toe on right after the pat salto. That elevates the level of difficulty. Oh. Almost took that handstand a little too far. Full twisting double back. Oh, a little hop back. But so many great things in that routine.
And already before her, Victoria Wynn, and 9.95 career high for her. Moments ago, Raina Worley coming after Isabella Magnelli scored a 9.9, the high score for Kentucky on the vault.
Notice that number to her left, a 4.15. This is a 1.5 twist in Yurchenko. That's how the judges know what to expect. Great in the air, but a hop to the side, so a little landing deduction there.
Well, she has been such a consistent all-around competitor for Kentucky, the senior from Virginia. In all 10 meets in the all-around, what a season, and she's gotten better each week. Trinity Thomas will be next up on bars for Florida. You see her bars NQS. NQS stands for National Qualifying Score. That's essentially the average, which includes some home and away scores. And that's how they rank the athletes individually and the teams as they go into postseason.
And you can bet Trinity is going through all her mental cues for this routine.
Kayla DiCello, a 9.9 before her. So no score for Florida on bars under 9.9 yet.
Watch the details, the handstands. Trying to show off every element in this routine to its fullest. Beautiful Van Leeuwen up to the high bar. Shows off that final handstand and watch the one of the most gorgeous double layouts in the country. And that is stunning. It's magnificent.
Kathy, with all of the 10s this year, the only event she hasn't scored a 10 on is bars. 6 times, she's gotten 9.975. What are they going to do with that?
Well, look at the perfection in that handstand, just vertical, straight body, and this is unparalleled. Landing with the chest up that high, no movement of the feet. Perfect technique in that double layout.
Well, the Florida 10 fans want to see their perfect 10. Remember, with 4 judges, you're gonna throw out the high and low scores. So to get a 10 here in postseason, 3 of the 4 judges have to agree that it's a 10 and you threw out the low score.
I was watching Trinity celebrate with her teammates and she tripped on the mat and everyone just started dying laughing. And she did it.
Oh!
It's a 10.
What a treat. All 4 judges unanimous. As they should be.
The roar of the crowd was just deafening. Unbelievable.
Trinity Thomas goes to her 26th perfect 10. The record is 28. And she has this meet, the regionals and the national championships to see if she can set the new record, one of the greatest of all time in college gymnastics. What a treat. And talk about great, Leanne Wong herself has scored perfection here.
I was just gonna say, Florida isn't done yet. On this event, they throw a high level of difficulty. They show off every piece of their gymnastics. You can tell she is trying to take this routine to its limit.
Oh, that was a quick step to the salute. I don't think they can give that a stick. And that was not her most perfect routine. But wouldn't everyone love to have one?
Oh, my goodness.
This good.
Execution is remarkable.
Absolutely.
Twice this year, she herself has scored perfect tens on this event, as she has on beam as well. What a start to this competition as we go now to Alabama on the floor.
Gabby Gladot opens with a full twisting double back.
Gladio's coming after Shania Adams, 9-9, in the third spot for Alabama. Just a freshman from Greensboro, North Carolina. 8 of 10 meets, she's been 9-9 or better on floor.
Finishes with her combination pass. Look at the amplitude on that split jump.
McCusker mounting the bars after Leanne Wong got another 9.95.
Strong finish for Alabama there on that floor routine. And look at the gorgeous execution. Phenomenal technique. Step on the landing. But so many skills in that routine are just beautifully done.
McCusker, the sophomore from Bradenton, Florida, originally, in 4 meets this regular season on bars. Haley Bryant now on beam for LSU. They have no scores yet in the 9-9s, but solid. Jeffrey and Shenikova have their best scores of 9.875s.
Very fluid connection on that front aerial to the back handspring. This routine comes up right after the full turn to standing front. She has so much power. Makes this look easy. As can, oh, little balance correction. When you lift the leg, that's a more significant deduction. Rudy for the dismount, 1.5 twist. Very, very good landing. They'll have to take the deduction for the balance correction and lifting the leg.
Lily Hudson now for Alabama after Gabby Gladio scored another 9-9. Alabama and Florida were tied coming into this rotation. However, Florida with a 49-7 on bars matches the SEC championship record. Their final routine, Riley McCusker had a 9-9. So no score below 9-9 for Florida on the bars. And a perfect 10 for Trinity Thomas. But look at the scores for Alabama on floor.
She opened the routine with her combination pass. We'll come back here with a difficult 2.5 twist. Watch the step out of it. Make sure it's not too big. Well done. lovely details in this routine. See if she can get the landing. Double tuck. Good control. Nice routine. A lot of nice footwork in that routine, really showed her dance training.
Lily Hudson 10 times in the all-around this year for Alabama as Aaliyah Finnegan gets ready to mount the beam.
Difficult routine, starting with a mount. That's a candle mount, but with a half turn to the chest stand.
Haley Bryant had a 9.825 before her. So all the scores for LSU between 9.8 and 9.875.
Triple series here. You get bonus for connecting these three difficult stills. Back handspring into two layouts. Nice cover, but she was slightly off and had a balance correction. Very precise on her leaps. Go above and beyond in terms of the level of difficulty. Aaliyah does that here on balance beam with the triple series, an additional aerial. Dismount, gainer full. Good landing and brings those heels together.
It's really hard to underestimate the impact that Aaliyah Finnegan and Haley Bryant have had on this team. They have been consistently in the all-around, just cranking out high-quality scores week in and week out. And Luisa Blanco now will wrap it up for Alabama in this rotation on floor after Lily Hudson's 9.95.
And this routine can be a masterpiece. It's such a high-energy routine, well choreographed. High double pike, a little bit of a slide with that front foot. Comes back with a tuck double back and perfect control on that landing. And this is where she shines. Beautiful footwork.
Three scores for Alabama so far on floor are 9-9 or better. They have an opportunity to notch a terrific team total in this second rotation.
From full to front layout, beautiful arabesque. Spectacular performance. She just performs so full out and with such great finesse on her footwork. Her leaps are beautiful. The tumbling, so well executed.
10 times they've won the SEC title and 6 times they won a national title. Alabama, one of the great programs in the history of college gymnastics. All right, there were a lot of highlights on that rotation. Let's take a look at Victoria Wynn from Florida.
They just put on a clinic on this event, really showing superb technique, mechanics, and execution. And so aggressive, just really attacked this event.
After all those incredible scores and then Trinity Thomas.
Nothing compared with this routine. It was just money. It was, she was so on from start to finish.
And that unanimous 10 means that's the second straight season gym slam for Trinity Thomas. Sam is with the head coach at Florida, Jenny Rowland.
Jenny, your score is the fifth highest in the NCAA on bars this season and matches the SEC championship record. What's your reaction to their performance today?
Amazing, incredible, and just really normal. The word for this week is normentum, the act of being normal with momentum, and really the team did a great job with that today.
How do you control their momentum heading over to Beam, which is a little bit different?
You know what? When they're loose, when they're happy, that's when they're at their best. They're normal. That's how this team performs. And really excited to finish off the last two events.
Thanks, Jenny.
Thank you.
All right, we're off to a terrific start here in session two of the SEC Championship. When we come back, we have a couple of former Crimson Tide gymnasts in head coaching positions. Sam Peschek will have more when we return.
Was an extremely successful gymnast herself. She was an athlete on the Alabama team from 2009 to 2013, not to mention a USA national team member before that. She was part of two teams that won the SEC championship title and also has experience winning two NCAA titles with her team. Well, I spoke to Ashley yesterday, and she said that she's really working on having this team let loose. She said she's ready for it. They've been trying to combine the dichotomy of this ultra-competitive environment with being light and fun. And she believes that's what's helped her team be so successful so far this season. And she's not the only former Alabama gymnast that's now a head coach. Asia Sims Fletcher will be the inaugural head coach for the Talladega College gymnastics program. As an athlete, Asia was an All-American on floor and beam, and she helped lead the Crimson Tide to back-to-back SEC championship titles and four consecutive NCAA Super Six finishes. Lucky for us, she's here. And yesterday, I got to catch up with her. Asia, what's it like being back to the SEC Championships?
It is so exciting. Such an honor to be here. Love helping out with this amazing event.
You got this incredible new position. Why did you want to take this job?
You know, it always goes back to just giving more opportunities. I'm so excited to help continue to make positive change in our sport and be able to provide more opportunities for athletes and gymnasts. So I'm so pumped to be able to be the first head coach.
This is the second HBCU program that has gymnastics. What do you think that means to the future and the growth of our sport?
That's right. It means just more, honestly. I mean, we're once again being able to provide more opportunities for more gymnasts to just be able to compete and enjoy our amazing sport. And then I also think it's being able to teach more life lessons to so many other athletes that you get to take after you graduate. So I'm really excited to be able to do this and help spread amazing culture into excellence in our sport.
Thanks, Asia.
Thank you.
Asia is so great. There's clearly exciting things to come for Talladega College gymnastics team and more excitement here. When we come back, we'll talk about one of Kentucky stars, Raina Worley.
Last year, Kentucky's Raina Worley went to the NCAA championships as an individual competitor, finishing 12th in the all-around. She said it was an exciting experience, and after being there as an individual, she's confident that this year she can get back there with her whole team. She was recently named a finalist for the AAI Award, honoring the top senior gymnast. It's essentially like the Heisman Trophy for gymnastics, and she's helped her team break into the top 10 as we push for the postseason. Here are the scores at the halfway point in this competition, including the four teams that competed earlier today. And the top four seeds are in the top four spots, with Florida over 99 points, which is on that 198 pace, which is essentially a 99 average pace, has the lead. What a competition, 48 routines, and everyone has been a hit.
That may be the most impressive stat of all. It's so wonderful seeing all of the athletes firing on all cylinders and hitting routines one after the other.
And deserving scores, no score under 9-8 tonight for anyone. Remember, it is a four-ring circus, a reminder that you can watch every single routine on SEC Network Plus. Each event has its own channel, plus you can watch the all-around channel with every event going at once.
We have two teams here competing on events where they are ranked fourth in the nation. Florida on beam, LSU on floor.
It's Gabby Gladio just opening up on vault for Alabama. On bars, Haley Davis for Kentucky finishing her routine.
Great leadoff. She has led off that event for the last 2.5 years.
And Sloane Blakely has just been on fire in those leadoff spots today for Florida.
Definitely has had sticky feet for sure. Oh, finish it off.
LSU's Sierra Ballard leading off the LSU Tigers. Currently in fourth, 0.4 of a point behind Florida.
Great performer on floor. Oh, pulled it around, that combination pass. Good start for Florida on beam. Not her very, very best, but a hit. Double bike here for the last pass to get LSU started.
That's a landing.
And a routine she's going to be really, really happy with.
The junior from Mandeville, Louisiana. She was only in two floor lineups last year and got injured. Great to have her back. She's done floor in all 11 meets for LSU this year. Jordan Paradise now for Alabama. They're off to a great start there.
1.5 twist here. Nice lift off the table. Good elevation. Good control on the landing.
Gabby Gladio led them off with a 9.95 on vault. Jimmy Rowland getting a couple of notes for Ellie Lazzari from Florida, who has become something of a beam queen, Gabby. Akari Daggett for Alabama on vault.
Another really good vault. Alabama is on fire. Ellie has been so consistent on this event. Very much a natural beamer. Triple series here. Handspring, two layout step outs.
When you use that term natural beamer, what does that mean in the gymnastic world?
Just every aspect of her beam work is superb, and it begins with that early training, and you can just see it in all the elements as she performs on beam, and just the ability to make tiny little corrections that nobody even notices.
Boy, she scored 9.925 on this event.
Adjustment on that landing.
Back to Alabama on vault. Makari Daggett had a 9.9. Here comes Lily Hudson. Big vaults for Alabama is a tradition.
They are throwing a lot of 10-0 vaults, and it is paying off a little under-rotated. That's too bad, because they'll have to take a deduction for the under-rotation as well as the hop back.
Still three solid scores for Alabama on this event with all of those 10.0 start value vaults.
Just didn't quite get the block that she would normally get, so couldn't quite rotate that fully around.
Lisa Blanco will come up on vault now for Alabama.
And this event is usually defined by the speed, the power, the strength, so that you can get the amplitude that you want to see on vault. Luisa adds another layer. It's a very pretty vault. Her form is often near perfect, just in terms of straight legs, the body shape, and toes pointed throughout.
That under-rotated vault by Lily Hudson earned a 9.825, but the high score there so far with the leadoff, and Gabby Gladio with a 9.95.
Very pretty in the air. That hop forward will be a deduction, but Alabama still rocking on vault.
Let's go back to Beam now for Florida. Kayla DiCello. Rosari had a 9.925.
This is an athlete who loves pressure, which is exactly what you want. As the pressure builds, as these competitions get closer and tighter, the ability to stay calm and focused under pressure is something that's so important as we get into postseason. Series, back handspring, layout, step out.
She's been in every meet for Florida on Beam, 9.975 twice as we go to Alabama on vault. Shallon Olson, their anchor vaulter. She's a former world medalist on this event.
Special treat, a Yurchenko double twist. The most difficult vault in the competition. And very, very well done. Good for her.
What a rotation for Alabama on the vault.
Does the hardest vault, sticks it cold. Good for her.
I think that's one of the best I've seen her do all year long.
So the only thing to look for here, because she gets it all the way around, is form. A little soft in the knees, but we're looking at it in slow motion, in replay. Judges have one shot at seeing the vault in real time to analyze it.
Shallon Olson, the graduate student, Olympian from Canada, competed as a member of their Olympic team in Tokyo. Alabama impressive in this rotation. Blanco's score was a 9.925, and Shallon Olson's score comes, Blanco was a 9.9. Shallon Olson's score comes in as a 9.925. So Alabama will drop a 9.825 and count all the scores above that for an outstanding rotation on vault. Puts them in the lead for the time being. Of course, vault finishes sooner than the other three apparatus because the vaults go quicker. The scores for Florida so far on Beam. DiCello, 9.95, Kathy.
So the scores have set Trinity Thomas up really well because this is an event that when she is on, she is so close to perfection every time. Gorgeous leap mount into another leap.
Of her 26 tens, three of them came on Beam this year.
One on back handspring into the layout, step out right here. Lines it up beautifully. Notice how quickly she moves in and out of her skills. This kind of pace is beautiful to see. Nice combination, deep jump to the handspring swing down. She has a beautiful routine going right now. Just the dismount, side aerial to a 1.5 twist. Oh! The teeny little slide on the landing.
She's Elena Arenas on floor now.
Looks like she stayed in bounds, but that was a big step out of the front double twist. Very nice amplitude on her leaps and jump.
She has adjusted their lineup all year long. Only the last four meets has Arenas been on the floor team. 9.95 last week, 9.925.
Wow.
an excellent front tumbler. She'll do her combination forwards as well. Front layout to a front full. Beautifully executed.
Raina Worley now after a superb rotation for Kentucky on bars. Shaylin Luksic before her, a 9-9-5. The last score, four scores are 9-9 or better for Kentucky on bars.
I love how linear this routine is. Everything is so streamlined, very straight handstand. She has a narrow grip that really makes the handstands look impressive. Big dismount, full out. Oh, just that little hop on the landing.
The last four scores for Kentucky on bars are career highs, a 9-9-2-5 for Worley would give Kentucky a program record on bars here in the third rotation as we look to Leanne Wong for Florida on beam.
Those leaps were so well done, really stretched through the core to show off the leap positions. One of the things she does best, her posture on beam, so stretched out of the hips, looks tall. Beautiful job so far, just the round off double twist, difficult to stick, and she does it superbly.
Twice this year, she scored perfect tens on beam as well as bars.
A lot of parts of that routine were so special. As I said, on those leaps, the amplitude and then the lift through the torso, really nice.
Wait, this meet is something like anything you can do, I can do better. As soon as she dismounts, here comes Aaliyah Finnegan for LSU on floor.
Opens with a very difficult Arabian double right into the stag jump.
Three scores, 9-9 or better for LSU so far.
So difficult, and she made it look easy. 2.5 twists to a punch front. Again, going above and beyond in the area of difficulty. Standing in the corner, Courtney McCool Griffith, the volunteer assistant coach. She does a magnificent job with the choreography, and there's her sister in the audience, of course, the great Sarah Finnegan.
Sarah, one of the most accomplished LSU gymnasts of all time as well. Talk about the quality of gymnastics. 17 of 22 routines so far in this rotation have scored 9-9 or better and deserved it. And that brings up Riley McCusker after Leanne Wong got a 9-9-7-5.
The polish in this routine, and she saved that double wolf turn. She was leaning back a little bit, but her fantastic training on this event. Look at the toe point, the perfectly straight legs. Just doesn't get better than that.
Only her third time in the lineup for Florida on beam this year. And did not compete as a freshman.
Handspring layout step out. Even shows the flexibility, slight balance correction. She scored a 9.95 in her first outing on beam. And the position of these leaps are just beautiful. Just the dismount left, gainer full. Really great routine. Yes, there were a couple slight balance corrections. They were very, very minor, but some of the elements of that routine are just head and shoulders above.
And we are in for a treat. Haley Bryant on floor exercise, double front.
Oh.
Wow. Okay. That was a stiff.
She's coming after Aaliyah Finnegan, had a 9.95. So four scores, 9.9 or better for LSU. Remember, they were in fourth coming into this third rotation, 0.4 of a point behind Florida.
Just perfect landings, great form. Do one of the most difficult final tumbling passes in the competition. And the gymnast open with a knee. Great position on those leaps. She opened the routine with an E. She is going to end this routine with an E skill, the highest level. Front double twist. Oh, that was incredible. Hands down the best routine that she has done all season long, and she's done some good ones. Let me tell you, she has done outstanding work all season long.
The quality of gymnastics tonight is unreal. Haley Bryant. She scored perfection on floor, 5.10s in 2023 for her, and another superb performance for the all-around athlete who has led this team through all kinds of turbulence this year, keeping them in the game. Jay Clark giving a few notes. Jay, of course, many years a former coach at Georgia. And then he moved over to LSU and has done a great job there. Kentucky in this last rotation was lights out on the bars, Kathy. Let's take a look at some of their highlights.
They were impeccable on their handstand positions, transitions, but the dismounts and landings were out of this world. One right after the other, doing their best routines when it matters most.
One season high and four career high for Kentucky. Look at that program record, 49-6 on bars tonight. Well done for the Wildcats. And LSU was superb on the floor in this rotation, and Sam Pesek is with their coach, Jay Clark.
Thanks, Bart. Jay, I was standing by your corral this entire rotation, and your team was celebrating each routine like they had just won the title. What does it mean to your team to just be here and competing so well?
It means so much. They've been through, I mean, it's been ridiculous how much they just got fight. They got so much fight. We started out a little rough, and we know it, but they started to settle down here a little bit. We just got to finish strong and then look up at the scoreboard and see what happens.
You guys are in it. What do you need to do to take the title for real?
We just need to stay true to who we are. It's the same message we've been telling them all year long. No timidity, all gas, no brakes, just have fun.
Thanks, Shane.
Thank you.
LSU is showing that they won't go down without a fight, despite missing some of their top gymnasts. We'll hear from some of them as to how they're staying positive and continuing to fight each week when we get back.
Welcome back to the second session of the SEC Championships. Three rotations down, and as you can see, it's still a close one. Florida's in the lead, but all four teams are within a half a point. Well, LSU is the Cinderella story coming into postseason due to injuries. They really had to rely on their depth throughout the season and even here tonight. Head coach Jay Clark told me they keep riding the adversity wagon and they keep eating it for lunch. So he told the team to have unshakable confidence and don't let timidity creep in. And two athletes that have done that throughout this entire season are Haley Bryant and Aaliyah Finnegan. Lucky for me, earlier this week, I got a chance to chat with them.
Aaliyah, your team has faced a lot of injuries this season, but you guys continue to compete at such a high level. How have you guys been able to keep the morale up throughout the season?
We've had so many ups and downs for this entire season, but each time, you know, we have the same goal, we're all on the same page, and I think that's really what keeps us connected.
What do you want people to know about the resilience of your team?
I think it's important for people to know that it looks easy from the outside looking in, but you know, there's a lot of hard work that goes on behind the scenes.
Haley, you haven't been able to rest a lot this year, but continue to perform at such a high level. What's keeping you going?
Honestly, in the gym, I kind of know what I need to do. Not too many numbers. Jay and the coaching staff has really worked with me in getting me what I need. If it's not as many turns that one day, so just being intentional with every turn I take.
What's the mindset heading into this postseason?
Just taking it one meet at a time, one event at a time, one person at a time, not getting ahead of ourselves and just doing what we do every single day.
Well, it's very clear from the outside looking in just how hard they've been working in the gym. Check this out. As they lost gymnasts due to injuries throughout the regular season, they continued to go up in the rankings, and they even won their meet against Florida. So it's all heart for this LSU team. So that's the question. Is heart enough to win the SEC championships? We'll find out when we come back.
We're getting set for the fourth and final rotation here, session two of the SEC Championship. Florida has the lead. Now, in that rotation, Kentucky had a program record of 49-6 on bars. LSU had a huge 49-6-2-5 on floor, the third best of the season for them. But both of them lost ground to Florida, who had a season high of 49-6-7-5 on beam. Just great gymnastics all around. Now, LSU will be in the upper left corner on vault. That is Elena Arenas. She'll be first. Lily Hudson is in the upper right corner for Alabama on the bars. In the lower left corner on the beam, it's Shaylin Luxick for Kentucky. And on the floor in the bottom right is Victoria Wynn from Florida in this fourth and final rotation. When this one's over, they will crown an SEC champion. Florida in control right now.
Buckle up, every half tenth counts. They will be fighting for everyone. Elena on vault, they are ranked third on this event, so they can go big, and that is one of the best Yurchenko fulls in the NCAA. Lily Hudson on bars. Nice finish, great landing. Shannon Luxick on balance beam for Kentucky. They're ranked 11th in the country here. And Victoria Wynn, always one of the most lovely, beautiful gymnasts on this event. Magnificent performance from the music swelling.
Elena Shenikova for LSU on vault at the same time.
1.5, good vault.
Elena Arenas led them off with a 9-9.
And a great start for Florida on floor exercise, where they are ranked 5th in the country.
Florida has a lead over Alabama, who is in second by 0.3 of a point. Coming into this fourth and final rotation, Alabama on the bars, Florida on one of their best events, the floor. Florida ranked in the top 5 in all 4 events with their team depth and consistency. Harris German from freshman from Spring, Texas at the World Champion Center. That's the home of Simone Biles. It's good to see her in the lineup today,
absolutely,
Kathy.
And you're going to love this skill. She does something very few do in NCAA. It's called a Rikna. It's a stalder into a reverse hack, and nice. Is superbly done. What a thrill. And a nice hack salto down to the low bar. A lot of difficulty in this routine. And so far, she is executing a little bit muscled on that final cast of handstand, but that's being picky. Because that, wow, what a treat.
Oh,
glad to see
nice.
That.
Rarely in the lineup, and boy, does she deliver here in the SEC Championship as she gets some congratulations from Gina Quinlan, second-year assistant coach there for Alabama. Jace Brock now for LSU on vault after Shenikova's 9.875.
And she has come up big for LSU. Oh, no. Mm. Too bad. Going for the more difficult vault. She's done a full before, but upgraded to this 1.5 twist.
Mitchell Bauman now for Florida on floor after Victoria Wynn led them off with a 9.9. As Aaliyah Finnegan takes to the vault for LSU.
Difficult vault here. Half on, front pike off. Well done.
They need a good score there because Chase Brock only had a 9.25 for LSU, currently in fourth place out of the four teams in this session.
Rachel Bauman has scored a 10-0 on floor exercise before a difficult combination pass. She twists both elements. Her dance is so good, the training so obvious. Look at the amplitude, over split, and the extension.
I'm a graduate student from Plano, Texas, the younger sister of Alyssa Bauman, a former Florida standout. Rachel went to Georgia and just transferred to Florida for her final season.
She'll end this routine with a double pipe. Watch the form, straight legs, pointed toes, even in difficult tumbling. Great landing.
And Jordan Paradise on bars for Alabama at the same time.
Jordan was a teensy bit short on that final handstand, but wow. Maybe they'll forget that because that dismount and that landing was fantastic.
Moments ago for LSU on vault after Aaliyah Finnegan had a 9.9. They need a hit here.
Throwing a Yurchenko full. Oh. And gets the landing. It's I'll a 9.95 start value. But she gave very little away and certainly not on the landing.
She landed a mile from the vault table. Give her that stick crown, Sam.
Yeah, guys, and she's having a lot of fun. I overheard her tell her teammate, my mouth hurts because I'm smiling too much. So caution, if you do college gymnastics, your mouth might hurt from smiling. I know you've been smiling a lot tonight, Kathy.
Don't try this at home, people. Oh, my God. That is such a beautiful vault. Didn't quite get the stick on the landing, but.
Haley Bryant, one of the best vaulters in the world, scored a perfect 10 on her vault.
It's amazing. She takes off from the front of the table, travels a mile, spots the landing, just always a treat.
Imagine how good it would be to have that technique and that power. She is a superb athlete.
Can't imagine it.
Oh, goodness. Maddie Alagora now for Alabama on bars. Jordan Paradise had a 9.9. They were thrilled with that.
Wait till you see her dismount. It is very difficult and superb technique. But first, giant blind to a nice high straddle Jaeger.
Peyton Richards starts on floor after Bauman notched a 9.925 for Florida.
Oh, nice final handstand. Let's see if she can get this full twisting double layout. It's huge on the bars. Great landing. That was great.
The toughest dismount in college gymnastics, and she drills it.
Here comes a double layout on floor. Great height, little leg separation throughout. Twist both elements in her combination pass. The first one at back 1.5 twist. Right out of the round off, 1.5 and front with a full. Well done. She knows it. Just a little excited. There are smiles all around. I think there's a lot of people with injured mouths smiling so big because they are performing to the hilt.
Richards, the senior from Mokena, Illinois. Back to bars now. Cam Machado after Maddie Walagora had another 9-9, the second one in a row for the Crimson Tide.
Maloney down, right into the pack. Slight leg separation again. I remind people the judges may or may not see those from the side. The third release transition with that Van Leeuwen up to the high ball. Let's see if she can get the stick here. Oh, not quite, little hop.
Ariana Patterson on beam for Kentucky. Moments ago, Bailey Bunn before her had a fall, a 9-2. So only two mistakes so far in this incredible competition.
Ariana has improved so much on this event in terms of her confidence, especially in these pressure situations. And there's more now because of the fall. Look at the height. What a floaty back handspring layout step out.
Kentucky still on pace to perhaps have their best finish ever at the SEC Championship. They've been fourth twice. Could better that tonight.
Nice how she kept those arms moving out of that front aerial to go right into the next skill. Just the gainer. First the lead pass. Nice showing of that full split. And Gaynor Pike off the end. Oh, not quite a stick, but a really strong reset routine for Kentucky.
Leanne Wong will be up now for Florida on floor. You see their scores, 9-9s and a 9-9-2-5 so far. Luisa Blanco on bars at the same time for Alabama, coming after Machado's 9-9.
Oh, beauty of watch. These are two great routines. Suddenly Arabian, she was a little short of on the rotation. Luisa Blanco is lights out so far, hitting the handstands every position. Full twisting double back and just a slight hop in place on the landing.
Three scores before her were 9-9. So Alabama finishing strong in the fourth and final rotation. What a meet the Crimson Tide have had.
You can see the disappointment on her face because those landings, though she covered and tried to camouflage the short rotation, they were obvious enough for a deduction.
Talk about all-around stars. Few have contributed as much to their team as Ariana Worley. Here she is on beam now for Kentucky. Ariana Patterson got them back on track with a 9-9. Remember, they want to drop the 9-2 and count five solid scores, and they could finish their best ever in the SECs. Anything more than fourth would improve Kentucky's finish in history here at the championships.
And Raina Worley is tough as nails in this situation. As strong as she is physically, she is mentally. And this is an athlete who prepares for situations like, oh! Tried to cover it, but that's definitely a balanced deduction. Came back strong with the layout step out. On top, very solid. Round off 1.5 twist. Really strong routine. There were some little deductions, though, in there.
Trinity Thomas now on floor. 9-6-7-5 or better for her here will clinch the championship. Would be the 12th championship for the Florida Gators in the SECs.
This routine is choreographed to showcase parts of all of her routines from her freshman year all the way through this super senior year. Oh gosh.
Stunning.
That is just magnificent.
A 9-9 would clinch the all-around title here for Trinity Thomas. She's on pace.
Fun full to front row. So
just a masterpiece. This would be a repeat of the all-around title. Just put it in the books. Oh my goodness.
And what a flourish to finish this routine. One of the most admired gymnasts in the country. No one does a double layout like this. Legs glued together, flying through the air, finding the landing every single time.
How do you go so high and so far and yet land with such finesse? It's just magic.
You're gonna have to ask Trinity that one.
Her teammates want a 10. Remember, there are four judges. The high and low score is thrown out. She's already gotten 110 tonight on the bars, her first of the year. There it is, another unanimous 10. Trinity Thomas moves to 27, the NCAA career 10s. One short of tying the record held by Jamie Dancher and Jenny Hansen, and she's not even close to being done with the postseason.
I mean, that is just perfection personified, and one of the most gracious, humble gymnasts in the country throughout her entire career.
And after that, we get an encore performance. Kayla DiCello, the freshman, coming after Trinity Thomas. This will be the final routine on floor for Florida.
opens with a front double full. Elevation and position in the air on those leaps. Florida's choreographer, Jeremy Miranda, has done a fabulous job this year creating these routines. Just for scores, but the gymnasts love performing them. What a show.
From the graduate student Trinity Thomas to the freshman Kayla DiCello, a world medalist, and now an SEC team champion with the Florida Gators. What a treat. Florida will win this. They have a 198-275, but they'll drop the score of Leanne Wong, which is a 9-8, so they will improve upon their team total. Alabama guaranteed second, and boy, did they do a heck of a job. Best score of the season for the Crimson Tide. LSU, 197-8, also impressive. And Kentucky with a 197-675. 9-9-2-5 for DiCello would be SEC champ records in the team score. Here it comes, and here comes the trophy. 9-9-5, they've done it. Not only do they win, but the 198-425. A half a point ahead of second place Alabama, who was spectacular today.
They were all just amazing. I mean, this conference just pushes each other to greater and greater heights. What a show they all put on tonight.
Cap off this SEC season. Florida Gators, their 12th title, a championship record with a 198-425. Trinity Thomas wins her second straight all around at the SEC championships. Start to finish, the Florida Gators unstoppable. We'll be back to wrap it up here from Duluth, Georgia. What a thrilling finish to the SEC Championships. Do not go away. We'll talk to the champions when we come back. Alabama's Pro Day is Thursday right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Bryce Young and Cam Latu highlight the Crimson Tide players looking to showcase their skills for NFL scouts and the front office personnel. Our two-hour coverage begins at 1 Eastern, noon Central, from the Hank Crisp Indoor Facility. What a thrilling night of gymnastics here in the SEC Championship. Florida wins their third highest overall score in Florida history and a SEC Championship record of 198-425. Alabama finishes in second with their season high. Sam Pesek is with the champion Trinity Thomas, but first let's take a look at some of her spectacular moments.
I've run out of superlatives to describe her gymnastics. She was so spot on. Perfection personified. And at the SEC Championships,
And she ties Jenny Hansen, who back in 1994 also scored two 10s in a single SEC championship. And of course, she is chasing Jenny Hansen's perfect 10 record of 28. Let's go down to Sam.
Congratulations on a phenomenal performance. You've had a lot of pressure on you this year. Not to mention, it's your last year, it's SEC championships. How did you control that pressure and score two perfect 10s tonight?
Yes, honestly, I will say this 1,000 times over. I could not do what I do without my family, and that includes my team, my friends, and obviously my family too, and I'm just so thankful for them and their support, because I put a lot of pressure on myself as well, and they helped me all the way.
Was your training at all different this week?
It was a little bit different this week. I got sick about in the middle of the week and got on antibiotics and everything, and was just taking it easy a little bit and was hoping that I would be good for today, and luckily, the Lord came through.
I think you were more than good today. What does it mean to you in your last year to win the all-around title and to win the SEC title with your team?
Oh, I didn't know that. Well, that means the world. I go out there and do my best, and whatever my best is, you know, I can't control the scores. So I'm super thankful, super blessed. Yeah.
Thanks, Trinity.
Thank you so much.
Well, Trinity Thomas has earned every 10 of her 27, and she's one short of tying an almost unrealistic 28 perfect 10s that Jenny Hansen and Jamie Dancher hold from years ago. But Trinity Thomas is nowhere near done. And what a night for Florida. Their third highest overall score and an SEC championship record. And Sam Pesek is with their head coach, Jenny Rowland.
Yeah, guys, Jenny was busy celebrating, so I'm interrupting her. She's also nervous to follow Trinity's interview. But I was watching you celebrate with your team, and you got a little emotional. What does this championship mean to you guys?
Really, any championship, it never gets old. It never gets old. It's the time, it's the journey, it's the highs, it's the lows with these young women, and I am just so grateful to be a part of their lives and to be able to celebrate this moment with them.
Thanks, Jenny.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations to the Florida Gators. Their 12th SEC title and a well-earned one tonight in a spectacular night of gymnastics. We'll be back to Duluth, Georgia to wrap this one up in a minute.
Gorgeous.
That routine was excellent.
That is just mind-boggling.
Unbelievable performance.
That's a superpower.
Oh, it's hard to believe we could have it any better than what we had tonight, but we'll have a great championship battle next month in Fort Worth. Two semifinal meets on ESPN2 on April 13th. For the first time ever then, a live pregame show leading into the championship final on Saturday, the 15th of April, live on ABC. And don't forget, in 2 weeks, we'll have all the regional sites streaming on ESPN+. What a thrilling day of gymnastics, start to finish, Kathy, with all eight teams in the conference, and the quality just gets better and better.
All four teams in this last session were great. Two teams were extraordinary, and I happened to look down on the floor and capture a wonderful moment. Jenny Rowland, Ashley Priest-Johnson hugging, holding each other, because what a moment for both of them. They were both just stellar tonight from start to finish.
Both Florida and Alabama had their best meets of the season, and they did it in the championship tonight. Luisa Blanco was outstanding for Alabama.
Just so beautiful in every way. Elegant, polished, and just right on form on everything. Controlled the landings. Fought for every tenth of a point. showed the amplitude, the difficulty in the gymnastics, making it all look easy as she always does. Fought hard to finish in a field of great all-arounders to finish as runner-up.
As good as she was, of course, Trinity Thomas, the second time in a row, the SEC all-around champion, leading her Florida Gators to the win, their 12th title in program history. So Florida wins your 2023 SEC Championship. Tune in now for the SEC Championship Award Ceremony on the SEC Network Plus. Thanks to our superb producer, Carol Lagana, and director, Dan McMahon. I'm Bart Connor, joining Kathy Johnson-Clark and Sam Peschek, saying so long from Duluth, Georgia. The Florida Gators win.
.9925 scores for Kentucky's Raina Worley and Caitlin DeGuzman. And a four-way tie for second place. Identical scores of .995 for Missouri's Helen Hu, Kentucky's Shaylin Luksic, Florida's Leanne Wong, and Florida's Victoria Wynn. And ladies and gentlemen, the 2023 Uneven Bars champion in the Southeastern Conference with a perfect 10 score from the Florida Gators, Trinity Thomas. Congratulations, Trinity, and each of our bars finalists tonight. Now to the balance beam. Sixth place tie. 9925 are the scores for LSU's Aaliyah Finnegan, Florida's Trinity Thomas, and Florida's Ellie Lazari. Second place ties on the balance beam, each scoring 9.95. Missouri's Helen Hu, Kentucky's Isabella Magnelli, Alabama's Luisa Blanco, and Florida's Kayla DiCello. And ladies and gentlemen, the 2023 Southeastern Conference Balance Beam Champion with a 9.975 score from the Florida Gators, Leanne Wong. Congratulations, Leanne, and all of our finalists tonight. And now, ladies and gentlemen, on to the floor exercise. A four-way tie for sixth place. 9925 are the scores for LSU's Chase Brock, Kentucky's Haley Davis, Alabama's Luisa Blanco, and Florida's Rachel Bauman. We also have a four-way tie for second place. Identical scores of 9.95. For LSU's Haley Bryant and Aaliyah Finnegan, Alabama's Lily Hudson, and Florida's Kayla DiCello. And ladies and gentlemen, the 2023 Southeastern Conference Gymnastics Floor Exercise Champion with a perfect 10 score from the Florida Gators, Trinity Thomas. Congratulations, Trinity, and all of our finalists tonight. And now, ladies and gentlemen, in our all-around competition, sixth place in the all-around, 39-6 even, is the score for the Florida Gators, Kayla DiCello. A tie for fourth place, 39-6-2-5 are the scores for LSU's Aaliyah Finnegan and Florida's Leanne Wong. Third place in the all-around, 39-6-5 for Auburn's Cassie Stevens. And second place in the all-around with a 39-6-7-5, Alabama's Louisa Blanco. And ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 Southeastern Conference Gymnastics All-Around Champion with a 39-8 even score from the Florida Gators, Trinity Thomas. Congratulations, Trinity, and all of our all-around finalists tonight. These are some of the very best gymnasts in the world. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we will recognize the winners of the team competition. Teams, please stand when you are recognized. An eighth place finish with a 196-6 score for the Georgia Bulldogs. Seventh place. 196-8-2-5 is the score for the Arkansas Razorbacks. Sixth place with a 197 even, the Missouri Tigers. Fifth place with a 197-1, the Auburn Tigers. Fourth place, 197-6-7-5 is the score for the Kentucky Wildcats. Third place with a 197-8-0, the LSU Tigers. Second place with a 197-9-2-5, the Alabama Crimson Tide. And ladies and gentlemen, the 2023 Southeastern Conference Gymnastics Team Champion with a 198-4-2-5, the Florida Gators. Thank you. Southeastern Conference Assistant Commissioner Misty Brown is presenting the 2023 SEC Gymnastics Championship Trophy to the Florida Gators. On behalf of the Southeastern Conference, thank you to all of the fans who came out to support the best in women's collegiate gymnastics at the 2023 SEC Gymnastics Championship. Once again, congratulations to our team and individual champions, and good luck to everyone competing in the NCAA Regionals and the National Championship.